You don't have to know how to use Illustrator or After Effects to create logo animation. If this is your first time creating a logo animation, then this video is just made for you. Let me show you how I created the following three different logo animations. Visit the following website, animeco.com, and sign up for a free account. You will be redirected to the dashboard. From here, select the following options to create a new blank project. The interface of Animeco is so simple. The center part where we'll be creating our video is called the workspace. On the right hand side is the scenes section. It is similar to the slides in a presentation. Similar to how slides combine to form a presentation, several scenes together form a video. At the bottom, we have the timeline. It has two more sections, scene timeline and overall timeline. The scene timeline lets you edit the individual scenes, and the overall timeline lets you work with the audio tracks and other video editing options. On the left-hand side is the library. It has all the elements that we need for creating a full-fledged animation and live-action video. If you want to learn how to create animated videos with characters, then check out our channel. Let's start with changing the color of the background. Click on the change color option present right above the workspace. Now select the new color that you want for the background. As the next step, we are going to add the logo to the scene. Open the properties section of the library. Here there are more than 70,000 customizable icons that we can use to create logo animations. Use the search option to find a logo that you like. Click on it to add it to the workspace. You can further customize the colors present on the logo in the same way we customize the colors on the background. Let me change the skin color of this dog. With the logo selected on the timeline, you can notice a colored bar. By adjusting this, we can control the visibility of the logo in the workspace. For example, let me keep the bar between the 1st and the 6th second. The logo will be visible only during this duration. This is how you can control the visibility of any element added to the workspace. Right now the duration of the scene is 10 seconds. I want the scene to end a little early. Let me reduce it to 6 seconds using this minus icon present on the timeline. Vice versa, you can increase the duration using this plus icon. Right now the logo is appearing without any effect. Let's apply an animation effect to it. Select the animation option present right above the workspace. Now you can select among more than 50 different animation effects. On the timeline you can notice the animation effect in the form of an highlighted part. You can control the duration of the animation effect using this. As the next step, we are going to add a special effect. Open the effects tab on the library. Here you can find a lot of different effects. Let me use this one over here. We are going to customize the colors present on this effect. Let's add the text. Open the text section of the library and click on one of the text boxes over here. Now type in the text. On the left hand side, you can see the options to edit the text. You can change the font style here. We can also change the font size and alignment. Let me change the font color and rotate the text to 45 degrees. Let's adjust the visibility of the text using the bar on the timeline and apply an animation effect to it. As the last step, we are going to add a camera effect to the scene. Click on the camera timeline. Now further, select this little toggle over here and select the dynamic camera option. Now we can see an highlighted part in the timeline. It represents the duration for which the camera effect is going to take place. Let me extend it till the end of this scene's duration. On the workspace, you can see the camera's frame. Adjust it and keep it on the part of the workspace where we want the camera to focus on. Our first logo animation is ready, and that too in less than 5 minutes. You can download this logo animation either as a video or as a GIF using the publish option over here. So that is how easy it is to create a logo animation using Animaker. Let's start with adding colors to the background. Last time the background had just one color, but for this logo animation, we are going to create a gradient background with multiple colors by using this plus icon over here. You can add up to 5 different colors. For this example, I'm just using 2. This logo is for a women's clothing brand. Let's add a logo from the properties section that looks like a woman shopping. Let's customize its color. Let's apply an animation effect to it. I want the logo to enter the scene from the left side, so I'm selecting this animation called Enter from Left. Right now the logo looks like walking in the air, so let's add a line that looks like a floor. I'm going to use this square shape from the library and convert it into a line by dragging its edges. Let's change its color and apply an animation effect to it. I want the line to appear as soon as the character enters the scene, so I'm keeping the line right next to the character on the timeline. As the next step, we are adding the brand name. Select a text box from the library and type the brand name. Let's customize its font style, size, and spacing. We are going to add a special effect to the text. Here you can see several effects. I'm using this hollow effect for this example. Let's apply an animation effect to the text. The text should be visible right after the character moves in, so I'm adjusting the text on the timeline based on that. Let me add the tagline by adding one more text box. Let's customize its style, size, color, and add an animation effect to it. Let's reduce the scene's duration to 7 seconds. As the last step, I'm adding the camera effect to the scene. As we have already seen how to do this, I'm fast forwarding this part. You can download the logo animation using the publish option at the top. In the previous examples, we saw how to animate using the animation option. In this example, I will introduce you to a new option called Smart Move, which lets you custom animate the objects. I've already added the logo and set up the background for this animation. The steps are very similar to what we did for the previous logo animations. As the next step, we are going to custom animate the text using the Smart Move option. I have added the letter L in a separate text box and the remaining letters in a separate box. There is a reason why I did this. If we look at the logo animation, at first the word logistics appears and then the letter L moves towards left and the remaining letters move towards right and the letter E appears. So we have to animate each of them separately. Let's start with the letter L. With the text box selected, select the option named as Smart Move. As you can see, the text box will be moving between these two spots. By default, it will move from the spot on the left towards the right, but we want the text to move towards left. We can make that happen by keeping the second spot to the left of the first one. On the timeline, you can see two thumbs. They represent the time taken to move between these two spots. Let's give around 0.5 seconds for this animation. Similarly, I'm going to move the second text box using the Smart Move option. We want both of them to move at the same time, so let me place the thumbs on the timeline at the same duration. Once the text boxes move, the letter E should appear. So let me add the letter E in a separate text box. Adjust its position on the timeline and make it appear after the Smart Move animation gets over. Let's apply an animation effect. Let's preview this logo animation. So this is how you can custom animate letters or even objects and logos using this option called Smart Move. Now you can download the animation using the Publish option at the top. Now that you know the easiest way to create logo animations, it's time for you to give it a try. Hope you guys found this tutorial helpful. If you are new to the channel, please make sure to subscribe and share your thoughts on the comment section. For more such tips, you can follow us on our social media handles, for which I am adding the links in the description.